Hi, my name is Jonna with Harmony Family Center. Thanks for joining me today for Storytime with Harmony. I'm going to be reading The Angry Octopus. Now, this is an interactive story, so please feel free to join me as we go through the book. The sun's morning light trickled down through the water to the entrance of a cave. An octopus sleeping inside the cave could feel the energy of the sun touch his face. He took a deep breath and opened his eyes. He stretched his body and ventured outside of his home. Just in front of his cave was a seashell rock garden that he had created. Each morning he would begin his day by eating his breakfast, munch, munch, munch. In his special garden, as he watched the ocean come alive in the morning sun, that must be a special garden. This morning, his garden looked different. During the night, lobsters traveled across the ocean floor and bumped into his seashells and rocks. Oh my. Everything was knocked over and out of order. The octopus was not happy. In fact, he was very angry. I would be very angry too. The more he looked at the mess, the worse he felt. He got madder and madder, and his body felt tighter and tighter. His muscles were tense and his stomach was rumbling like a volcano. He looked around at his ruined garden and his face started to turn red with anger. He knew what was happening to him, but he did not know how to stop it. He was so angry that he thought he might explode. And he did. The angry octopus lost his temper, and as he screamed and yelled, he released a purplish-black cloud of ink over the water around him. He felt so frustrated and out of control, he didn't feel like he was the boss of his own body or his own feelings. And now, he couldn't see through the dark ink cloud surrounding him. Poor guy. A sea child swimming by the cave saw the cloud of anger and confusion and stopped to speak to the octopus. "Why are you so angry? Why are you sitting in a dark cloud on such a beautiful day?" The octopus answered that he didn't know why he always did this when he got angry, but he did know that it didn't feel good to lose his temper, and it always made his problems get worse. The sea child giggled and said, "I will show you how to be the boss of your own body and your anger. I'll show you how to calm down, let go of your anger, and see things more clearly." Okay, so this is where it gets fun. I'm gonna read you part of the story and then we're gonna try it too. Lie down on your back and wiggle yourself into a comfortable position. Feel the sand moving slowly around your body as you snuggle in. Now close your eyes and take a deep breath. Breathe in through your nose and let the air out of your mouth. Now, we know you're not in the ocean because I'm not in the ocean either, but what we can do is snuggle in tight right where you are and relax your body. And we're gonna breathe in through our nose and out through our mouth. Ready? Try it with me. Breathe in. Breathe out. Good job. Let's keep going. Now tighten your toes and feet. Squeeze them as tight as you can. Squeeze them tight into a ball. Hold, hold, hold. Now let the air out of your mouth and let your toes and feet relax. Surprisingly enough, the octopus felt his toes and feet relax. Okay, so now it's our turn. Okay, we're gonna hold on the count of three. Remember to squeeze your toes really tight, but not too tight. And three, two, one. Hold, hold, hold. Your mouth and relax. Oh my, I know my toes feel a little silly right now. The sea child continued, tighten your legs tight as you can. Squeeze them as tight as you can and hold, hold, hold. Now let the air out of your mouth and let your legs stretch out gently as you let the angry tight feelings start to slip away. The octopus felt his legs stretch out on the cool sand as he let the angry feelings leave his body. Okay, our turn. So we're gonna hold our legs as tight as we can. Breathe in, hold, 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 and out. Ready? Okay, we're gonna squeeze our legs as tight as we can and breathe in. Hold, hold, hold. Now relax your legs.
The sea child continued. Tighten your hips, stomach, and back. Squeeze them as tight as you can and hold, hold, hold.
Ah, now let the air out of your mouth and let your back, stomachs, and hip melt into the sand beneath you.
The octopus felt his body melting into the soft sand beneath him. The rumbling in his stomach became quiet and was now replaced with calm air as he felt his breath move in and out, in and out, in and out.
You know what that means. It's our turn. Breathe in, squeeze your hips. Hold, hold, hold. Breathe out and relax. Good job.
The sea child continued, tighten the muscles in your chest, your neck, and your shoulders. Squeeze them as tight as you can. Hold, hold, hold. Now let the air out of your mouth and feel all the tension in your chest, neck, and shoulders drift away. The octopus felt the tension leave his chest, neck, and shoulders and drift away.
All right, I know you're ready for this one because it's our turn and our bodies are pretty warmed up. So this time we're gonna do our chest, shoulders, and neck. Remember, breathe in and squeeze. Ready? Breathe in, squeeze, hold, 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 and relax. And he felt his worries drift away. Can you guys drift away with me? Ready? Drift away.
The sea child continued, tighten your arms, hands, and fingers. Squeeze them into a tight ball. Hold, hold, hold. Now let the air out of your mouth and let your arms, hands, and fingers unfold. The octopus felt his hands open and the last of his anger float away.
All right, you guys are pros at it now. Remember, it's our arms, our hands, and our fingers. So we're gonna squeeze tight. Hold, 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 and relax. And remember, this was the last of his worries that floated away. So are you gonna float with me? Float, float, float.
The sea child continued, tighten your jaw, your lips, and your nose. Crunch your whole face. Squeeze them as tight as you can and hold, hold, hold. Now let the air out of your mouth and let your face and skin soften.
Now, we're gonna squeeze our jaw, our lips, and our nose as tight as we can. Hold, hold, hold. Relax. Good job.
The sea child continued, tighten and wrinkle the skin on your forehead and the thoughts in your head. Squeeze them as tight as you can. Hold, hold, hold. Let the air out of your mouth and let your forehead and mind become smooth and clear and still.
All right. We're gonna squeeze our forehead and our thoughts. Ready?
Hold, hold, hold. Relax.
Good job. We're almost done.
The octopus stayed very still for the next few moments. He realized that he was now the boss of his own body and his feelings. He felt his breath moving in and out and in and out and touching every cell of his body. He felt good.
We're gonna do it too. We're gonna sit still for 5 seconds, maybe a little more, and just focus on our breathing. Ready to try with me? Don't forget to close your eyes. I know that that's a little bit hard for me, so thanks for trying.
A few moments after the octopus opened his eyes, his mood had shifted and the color of his body had returned to a warm shade of brown. He felt calm, balanced, and comfortable in his own skin. The dark cloud that had surrounded the octopus was gone. The ever-moving ocean had replaced it with the pure blue water. In this calm, still moment, he realized that he could see things more clearly. He realized that he could solve problems without being angry. With a little help, he could fix his seashell garden. The octopus asked the sea child if she would help him. Together they worked and laughed as they created a new seashell garden. Being the boss of his angry feelings helped the octopus to make a new friend. Being calm helped him to see new possibilities. It helped him to think clearly. Now, whenever the octopus feels like he's going to explode with anger, He takes a deep breath. Ready? Let's do it together. Good job. He tells them that he's the boss. He tells himself. He doesn't tell them. He tells himself that he's the boss of himself. He remembers that being calm helped him to fix his garden and make a new friend. He smiles at how much better he feels as he breathes in and out, in and out, in and out. Well, thanks for joining me today. I know that I enjoyed that story. And now we know a little bit more about being the boss of our own bodies. Don't forget to breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth and squeeze as tight as you can. Thanks for joining me today, and don't forget to practice your deep breaths.